Aloha, and welcome to our continuing educational series on the sacraments. The Eucharist, in many ways, is the signature sacrament of our Catholic faith. Although baptism is the first sacrament of initiation, the Eucharist is truly the source from which all sacraments flow. The celebration of the Eucharist in a Mass is where we often begin our journey of faith on earth, first in baptism and ended in a funeral. During our lives, we often celebrate other sacraments like confirmation, marriage, holy orders, and even anointing in the celebration of the Eucharist. Jesus himself celebrated the first Eucharist with the apostles at the Last Supper. And just as we here in Hawaii enjoy sharing a meal with family and friends, we as Catholics around the world share a sacred meal to remind us of the sacrifice of Jesus for the forgiveness of our sins. Jesus asked us to do this in memory of him, and he left us his presence in the form of food so that we could always be nourished and be with him always. He gives us our daily bread so we can also be broken and shared, and like wine be poured out in service and love for others. The literal meaning of the Eucharist is giving thanks, and so we give thanks for the opportunity to deepen our faith together as we seek to understand the true meaning of the Eucharist.
Christ is the source and summit of our salvation and all that we are, and it's in the Eucharist that we receive the body and blood of Christ. So the primary sacrament of the Church is the Eucharist. And for us, of course, as Catholic Christians, it's really what defines us.
Why is it good to receive Jesus in Holy Communion? What happens when we receive Jesus?
It reminds us of the baptism.
It reminds us of our baptism because we have Jesus' life in it. And that's what else happens when you receive communion? How does it help you? Yes.
It replenishes your heart, and it's about 20 times better than the blessing.
Wow, I think at least 20 times better, way better than a blessing, huh? Because actually, you're actually receiving Jesus, huh?
I've always thought it's not fair that other people get to eat the bread and I don't.
When she says, you know, why are we doing this? And then it's like, well, why can't I get communion yet? Because her brother had communion. Well, you haven't made your first communion yet. Yeah, but I'm Catholic. And so I had to explain to her that, you know, you need to learn certain things and understand why you're receiving God. And so, I mean, we talk about it a lot because she asks. And I think she gets it, mostly.
I feel like when I get my real communion that I'll know what to do and it'll be better for me.
We're all part of the same family. And when we receive communion, it reminds us that we are in union with one another.
Ohana means family, and family means no one gets left behind or forgotten. I know that people love me, and I know especially that Jesus loves me.
The meaning of Eucharist is to give thanks, and what we give thanks for mostly is the fact that God loves us so much that he sent his Son.
Jesus, he's the most important thing in my life. He gave up his whole life for us, just for us to be forgiven and go to heaven.
He wanted to be in us, and when he's in us, we follow what he did.
You are what you eat. The Eucharist is such a gift to us, to the Church, to the world. And when you encounter a gift like this, we know that it's Jesus Christ. It's the real presence of Jesus Christ. That's the most meaningful gift, I think, that we can offer our children.
It's a daily relationship. It's a relationship that has to be built and nurtured and nourished. And so that is why we go to Mass every Sunday and even celebrate Mass every day, so that we have the opportunity to build that relationship, to grow as we do in any relationship.
The Eucharist reminds us that we're all in this together, and we all are called to be the body of Christ. When we say that we are in the real presence of Jesus Christ. We believe that Christ is really present still in the Eucharist. And so that's why it's important to come together, because it's an affirmation of the central truth of Christianity, which is the resurrection, that, you know, Christ still lives, Christ is risen.
Knowing who you are in Jesus, you're free to be who God created you to be. And we're all so different, and we all bring our God-given talents to build the church and to belong to a community of faith.
In the Eucharist, in the church's minister, in the assembly, Christ is present here. And it's that sense that the Lord is with us, and that something incredible is happening every time we celebrate the liturgy.
The liturgy that families can come together to worship. The Ohana Mass is giving persons with disabilities not only an opportunity to worship, but to be an active part of the church, to be Eucharist. That's a much stronger Ohana for our church here in Hawaii.
Ohana doesn't only mean families. Family means only never left behind. Right?
We're all one family, God's family. So Ohana Mass, how does that make you feel that we're all family, God's children?
Yes.
In one church environment, right?
Yes, it's true.
O-H-A-N-A means family. Sundays, we help each other, the family. She's happy. Yep, she's happy.
The Roman Catholic religion is, in fact, a religion of joy. And Christ very specifically says, I have come that you might have joy and have it in abundance. God is good all the time. And that even through life's struggles and tribulations and trials, things that provide for hardship and chaos in our lives, that in the end, God will triumph.